So, as introduced this morning, I think the sessions in this meeting, we would like to have a panel discussion at it. And as introduced, sorry, Kees, go ahead. Sorry, Bibo, you have to move. So before coming here in San Diego, I sent a few of the questions that I would like to have discussed to the panel members, and I would like to have your opinions on a number of these topics, and of course your questions. So that's why I will run around with the microphone. And the first question that I have to the panel is, what is it that users really need? And I propose that Wim is actually the first to try to give an answer to this question.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether I'm going to really answer the question, but as I mailed you, my first response to your question was that when I tried to answer that question, I each time had to think about what type of user are you referring. So in my mind, there are basically two different types of users of the Transmart platform. And one of the type of users I recognize are the PIs, the principal researchers, the people that initiate the research projects. And on the other hand, you have, say, the people, the bioinformaticians, the biostatisticians, that really work with the data, do the analysis, prepare the publication, and they have different interests. The PIs and the principal scientists on the one side, and the people that do the work on the other side, and so they also have different needs.
So then name the species, and then add the needs from your perspective.
So from the PI. The data is important. So the data that it is available, that it is shared, that it can be reused, that it is maybe not initially publicly shared, but at least shared within the team, the research team, that is well curated, that it is. So that's the thing that's important, I think, for those type of species, as you say. From the other end, the bioinformaticians really need to work with the data, so they need to do the analysis. So they are interested, their needs are, the data should be in the format I would like to work with, or if Transmart cannot do it, it must be very easy to put the data in such a format that I can use it in my preferred tool. And that's quite a different need. So that's what I thought, and that's my answer basically on the two different types of species.
Yeah. Anyone wants to add or to comment on this?
Well, so basically, like, I really liked the example of the Movember study, in which it was stated like, no one is allowed to have data on their local systems. Like, you have to do the analysis within Transmart, and you created the extra environment in Transmart that the bioinformaticians have to use R inside of it, because Transmart is really a rigid system, and so far every bioinformatician that I have met is really not into it. They say, I have my R scripts, I'm not going to use Transmart. So in that side, it's more for the researchers, the PIs, as what do you have, how can I analyze my data, and the bioinformaticians, they at the moment are a step before that. So, and if you want to force them to use it, then Movember would actually be the way to go. They set an example.
But the way Movember, the way we went, has to do with the remark you made at the end of your presentation, also has to do with how Transmart will be structured. So, and in the new structure, it is prepared for this kind of different users. So the API makes, so we use the API to make it in Movember to make the data accessible within that environment. So it's part of course of the architecture of Transmart, whether it is capable of supporting this kind of use. So
one of the questions I have is, when we think about a Transmart implementation, and we think about metrics, what are the outcomes that we're trying to achieve by using Transmart? Is it best measured by the number of people using it, or by other outcomes in terms of, you know, affecting clinical studies, affecting patient care? What are the right metrics as we think about that?
Yeah, that's a good question. I try to take it. I think it's very different for different scenarios. So I think what Wim mentioned was more thinking from either a university setting or for a consortium setting, like public-private. If you add to that a pharma IT, which is also a user in this community, I think there we have a couple different users. One very prevalent use case in a pharma company is finding data. So my company has lots of data and I want to find and access research data. So then I would say a measure is how well is Transmart able to help me find the data that I need to answer my questions. And that could be, you know, primarily data sets, that could be analysis results in some cases. It could also be just how many studies have we on Alzheimer's disease from all the 100 plus collaboration my company's involved in. So I would say how, and in general, that's true from IT. So I think we're switching from a paradigm where IT was delivering a product, you know, Microsoft Windows, it came in a box, in a CD-ROM, you put it in your computer, you install it, and you have a version of the tool. Today, IT is all about how well can I help the customers in their ever-changing needs to do the things they want to get done. And that's really, you should be your metric. How well are you able to have your customer do their jobs? And because IT is constantly changing, or the needs are constantly changing, IT operations team and the product development team need to change as well with that.
I would maybe add one more comment. Maybe one of the metrics could be, for example, the publications or the results that come out using Transmart. Because actually, if the people are digging into the data, it's certainly to find out something that is new or that is not that was not yet foreseen. So I would tend to think that it could be a kind of a metric that would be interesting to see how many times, for example, Transmart is advertised in a publication.
I would even like it to be how many times can I open a publication and find the link of the data that are described so that I can actually, from that publication, open the data that is described in Transmart. That's what I would like. And I think we're not there yet, but that would be fantastic, because now all the translational research studies that are published in the major journals, like the New England Journal, they're very hard to actually verify what's in there is actually true, and they're impossible to do additional analysis that could be done and would be very valuable on that kind of data.
I have a follow-up to Keith's question. I think what you were looking for, ultimate improvement of healthcare, is an endpoint, but that is far down the road, and that has multiple causes, and not only the use of Transmart. So I think we, if we want to make the case that it's worthwhile what we're doing, we need to come up with intermediate endpoints, and I think user uptake is a very important one. But you could add several on top of that. You could also look at how many users, how many studies using the same type of disease are actually adopting the same vocabularies, and so that you get interoperability. And the example that Raymond was making, but for all practical purposes at this point in time, I would go for user uptake.
So then let's ask the question, what is it actually that users want? Do you want to start off, Mariska?
Well, basically users want to be able to do what they did without Transmart, which means that a lot of them will want to go into the domain pipeline, which is in trade, not the point. Like there's this distinguishment, like if you want to ask domain specific queries, you have to go up the pipeline, you have to use a tool like Chipster or R to analyze your data, but it is basically what the user wants. So if you then want to stimulate them, you need to get the most used analysis inside of Transmart and make them look nice. Like there are advanced analysis in Transmart. You've already seen the slides now showing you the new UI for Transmart. There is interactive viewing using Smart R analysis. And if you show the users basically Transmart before, as it is right now, you will get like kind of result, the feedback. But if you then show them these visualizations, they're like, ooh, I can click on a pie chart, I can now see my stuff. Hey, I can create this correlation plot and I can select stuff. It makes them happy. So new visualizations, new analysis, and also extra analysis through, for example, the Smart R, that you can see your proteomics data in different ways. So that is what makes users happy, actually.
Rita, what are your experiences from Matrix?
A part of my experience is that for even if the user are not aware of the possibilities that exist within Matrix, for example, the fact to have training, I think the users are not just do not want just to repeat what they did before. They want to learn new tools the same way as they learned with their smartphone or whatever tool. Fitbit or whatever, they want to learn about new tools that makes them feel more independent while doing their research. And this is a point that is really important, because if each time you have to pass through someone, oh, I would like to see this, but I don't know how to do it, can you do it? So it is translated in the language of the scientist, the computer scientist, which is not exactly the language of the research scientists. So I think the best way is to increase the level of knowledge of the research scientist in order for him to be able to use the tools and to be more, even more severe, I would say, about this tool and ask more and more and more about these tools. And I must say that from the experience that we had in Matrix, each time we have proposed a training, whatever level of training it is, whether it is for user of the curators, or it has always been received very enthusiastically, and people were very happy to have it. And then we had a lot of exchanges, and of course, after that, what is needed is a fast feedback for the questions or the problems that the user have. If the feedback is 2 years later, they are not interested also.
That sounds like a point of improvement that you're kind of mentioning. So how well did this go? So the people who followed the trainings, then afterwards, did they keep on using Transmart, or actually did they get frustrated because it was tough to start using it separate from the trainings?
They start using it. They can get frustrated with some point, and they file a ticket, and then we try to answer or we try to solve the problem if we can, and then we come back to them. But they always have an answer, whatever it's positive or negative, and then they go on using it at any level that they want to.
So that's a really nice that's a really nice feedback loop, like the user actually provides feedback driving then development back. Like also for the new analysis, it's really nice, but I still think also like how do you get users convinced? First is, for example, if they can reproduce their own analysis. So yeah, That's nice.
Yeah. Case, what do you think of users?
Well, again, I'm going back to my point about job to be done. In the end, you're going to use an application on your laptop or on your phone if you want to accomplish something with it. It's like an obvious truth. So what it comes down to is what does Transmart really help people accomplish? And the web interface of Transmart is just one aspect of the platform, right? Just one thing. It's an important thing because it's the most visible one. But users that really want to use that potentially is a group that I think Mariska was also referring to, that are not necessarily very computer savvy but still understand their data well. And so in that case, Transmart could help them see their data and access computational tools. Obviously, that's a tough area for Transmart to be in because there are so many tools providing that. I mean, you think about Spotify or Excel, and so Transmart's competing with all those tools. And as soon as Transmart is a little bit less optimal than Excel, people will actually go to the tool that does their job best. So this is one area where I agree you can add value. And the more you go into advanced things like the copy number variation example where you go, I mean, Excel would be really hard to use for that. So Transmart is great. You have no alternative. But there are other types of users too. So as I mentioned, you could be looking for data. So just using Transmart as a catalog. And I think actually we can improve the platform there to make it easier to look into data sets without having to request the full access. So like more like an intermediate portal. That could help. If it becomes mandatory in Europe, and it will be, Horizon 2020, IMI projects, to publish your data as FAIR, if Transmart out of the box allows you to tick that box, now I've published my data as FAIR, that would be a tremendous opportunity. Because now users suddenly have this new thing that they have to do. Right? I have to publish FAIR my data. It's just a box I have to tick. If Transmart can do it for me, you'll see big user uptake. So we have to look for jobs to be done. And another one that I didn't sort of mention already, but the data scientist could be a user, right? It could be using the R interface of Transmart. So in that case, it's about how easy is it for me to get data from the Transmart master database into my own analytical environment, whether that's R or Spotify or something else. But in the end, the person responsible for IT or informatics is also a user of the platform. And again, I'm going to come back to my example of the poster from Ben from AbbVie. Is here's a smart small team at AbbVie that is an informatics team, is serving a larger community of users. They are using Transmart too every day. And this is also how we at The Hive are using Transmart, namely as software that you modify and customize to a certain need. And that's another type of user we need to take into account. It's a very small group, but a very important group because they work on Transmart full time. People like Weibo, etc. And data creation, I think, is an aspect where Transmart can still develop more tooling so that it becomes easier. If your job is data creation, again, my job to be done is I get data from people and I need to put in Transmart. How does Transmart help me do that easier? Things like Arborist.
So I think you're already describing a number of aspects that are actually crucial to get users addicted to Transmart. Is there more ideas how you, I mean, your company thrives off more users, so what are your ideas about getting them addicted?
Well, obviously the FAIR aspect, I already mentioned that, that's something we need to look into.
And there you anticipate on the changing regulations and the stick in this case that forces scientists to publish their data as FAIR data.
Yeah.
And that is regulations internationally pushed forward equally hard, or is that in some areas more than others?
Well, publishing your data in Transmart is, I think, is something that globally can be done. Of course, as a Transmart community, we can do more to interlink and to network that and to showcase that, so all the data that's available.
But for me as a scientist who just want to publish something, that's not good enough. Then if I can publish without having to put my data in Transmart, then I will choose the quickest and easiest road to fame, right? So
yes.
At this moment, that doesn't include Transmart.
No, but if you're mandated to use FAIR, and if Transmart is one of the few solutions actually offering concrete, which it, to be clear, today it does not fully comply with FAIR, so we have work to be done. Like okay, not going into the details, but that's what I mean by the opportunity. So we want to get users addicted, provide them with something that they really need today, that they're willing to spend time on the platform. And I think if after a training you don't see user retention, that could just be because they found the training very interesting and they could do a lot of things with Transmart and they enjoy it, but it's not part of their job. And in the end, you have a job to do. And that's where you determine whether you can use something or you're not using something.
And follow up to what Kees was saying, I think we need to, as a community, position this also more explicitly, because what users want are simple things. They want immediate satisfaction on their problem, and as you were referring to, and they always want, at least from the perspective as researchers, as users, they want their next grant, and you mentioned already Horizon 2020. Well. I think that just like Raymond was referring to, that also their users will be looking for the cheapest way to tick that box. I think as a community, perhaps we should put some more effort in missionary work to actually convincing research funding organizations that that they actually should stress this a little bit further than perhaps they are considering to do so. And that is an area, I think, which we have not reached out to very much, and perhaps that's something that we should give a little bit more attention.
Well, not for Europe, you mean? For US?
No, I think also for Europe. The fact that it is somewhere in a grant description that you should comply with FAIR data, you would argue that Transmart is not complying with that. I would say, well, of course it is. You can find it, you can access it, and you can interoperate.
No.
Yeah. So, and despite what the FAIR community is hoping for, I don't think it's gonna turn out automatically that strict as you're anticipating.
Mm.
I think this is really gonna be we're front runners in this field, and there's going to be a lot of upset community that is going to face these obligations, so that will be relaxed to start with.
And I'm not convinced that in the US it's really much better than in the Netherlands. I recently reviewed a paper for the Journal of the National Cancer Institute, which I think would be an organization that kind of enforces to make your data publicly available. And as a reviewer, I could hardly judge the data, so I asked the authors, can you please show at least some of the data, at least in an Excel sheet or whatever? And the answer was, no, we submitted to this particular journal of the National Cancer Institute, because they don't require that. And it got accepted. Yeah. So I think there's work to do in Europe and in the US. I look at the time. And it's 4:30, and I think that's about the time that we close the session. So I actually would like to thank the speakers, the panel members, and the audience for participating in the discussion.